Debits and Credits. Every time a financial transaction is recorded in accounting, at least two of the major categories that we discussed have to be modified. For example, assets, liabilities, equity, revenue, expenses. Repeating the earlier example of buying an office chair for $50, cash is reduced by the $50 to pay for the chair, and assets are increased by $50 because the business now owns a chair valued at $50. Another way to show the above transaction is to use the accounting terms debits and credits, as shown in the table below. A debit means to increase assets or expenses and decrease liabilities or equity or revenue. Those are the five major accounting classes we discussed. A credit means to decrease assets or expenses and increase liabilities or equity or revenue. Now, you may not have to remember all of this perfectly, but if you are going to have a career in accounting, you will probably have to do so. So looking at the table below, we have two entries, the cash entry, which shows a credit, which is a reduction of cash of $50 to buy the office chair. And then we have an increase in assets, which is a debit of $50 to purchase the office chair. So assets are debited, cash is credited. Again, crediting cash means reducing it. Debiting assets means increasing assets. One easy way to remember cash and debit is to think of your debit card that you have with the bank. A debit card means you already have money that you can use, so it's called a debit card. Adding more money to your bank account actually increases your cash, which is a debit. So debit is an increase in cash. That's an easy way to remember debits with cash. Accounting prefers the terms debits and credits, which are sometimes abbreviated DR and CR, so DR for debit, CR for credit. These terms are used to avoid the confusion that could arise with the use of plus. These terms are used to avoid the confusion that could arise if you use symbols or words like plus or minus, or increase or decrease, because of the fact that some accounts are increased and others are decreased in certain ways. The words debits and credits are more accurately representative of what you should do. What you're seeing now are arrows that shows whether an account increases or decreases based on a debit or credit. So you can see assets increases if it's debited, and if it's credited, you want to decrease it. If you want to increase a liability, you would credit it. If you want to decrease a liability, you debit it. Equity is decreased on a debit, increased on a credit. Revenue is decreased on a debit, increased on a credit. Expenses are increased on a debit and decreased on a credit. This can be confusing early on, so it's nice to have an easy reference that you can look back on. You'll also have the option of playing a GoVenture business simulation where you can actually practice debits and credits. And if you practice debits and credits for some time, you'll find they become very natural, and you'll remember these things very easily.
GoVenture is one of the original and most widely used series of educational games and simulations in the world. Discover a better way to teach and learn at GoVenture.net.